A record hot March. Is this a new stage of climate change? This is News Review from BBC Learning English, where we help you understand news headlines in English. I'm Beth.
And I'm Georgie. Make sure you watch to the end to learn the vocabulary you need to talk about this story.
And remember to subscribe to our channel to learn more English from the headlines. Now, today's story.
Last month was the world's warmest March on record. The past 10 months have all broken heat records with above average temperatures across the globe, including in Antarctica and Africa. It's becoming harder to make predictions about future temperatures, although, because of climate change, scientists say that hotter weather is now expected.
You've been looking at the headlines. What's the vocabulary that people need to understand this news story in English?
We have usher in, on borrowed time, and caps.
This is News Review from BBC Learning English. Let's have our first headline.
This one's from CNBC. An extraordinary run of record heat could usher in a long, hot summer, and not in a good way.
So this headline says this run, that's a continuous situation, a run of record heat could usher in a long, hot summer. Now we're looking at usher in, and Georgie, this reminds me of the theatre.
Yes, an usher is someone who shows you where your seat is in a theatre or a cinema or a wedding, for example. But that's a person, a noun. But here it's used as a verb and it literally means show someone where to go.
Now, usher in is metaphorical. There are no people involved. And it means to mark the beginning of something new. Now, with the headline, the previous months of heat are metaphorically showing the next few months where to go and what to do next. Again, break heat records. And that would mean we get a long, hot summer.
Okay, so the heat is ushering in a long, hot summer. It's showing the summer the way to go.
Exactly. And we're going to usher in our next word. But first, let's look at that again. Let's have a look at our next headline.
This is from Al Jazeera. On borrowed time, world marks new global heat record in March.
So we're looking at on borrowed time. This is an idiom. Can you break it down for us?
Well, can I borrow your script?
Yes.
So I'm borrowing this. I have it now, but I'll have to give it back later because it's not mine. I'm only borrowing it. I can't keep it. So here you go.
Thank you. Now, if something is on borrowed time, it means it's lasting longer than expected, but time will run out eventually.
Yes, the world is heating up, and for many, it's still livable, but it won't be if climate change continues and the heat continues to rise. So we're on borrowed time because eventually humans won't be able to cope.
Now, we often also hear the expression living on borrowed time. So imagine a criminal, they keep breaking the law, they're going to get caught eventually. They're living on borrowed time.
Yes, they'll get caught and go to prison sooner or later.
Okay, let's look at that again. Let's have our next headline.
This one's from Deutsche Welle. Record hot March caps warmest 12 months on record, report.
So we are looking at the word caps. And Georgie, what are you wearing?
It's a cap, Beth. Is that not the word we're talking about?
Well, yes, it is. Now your cap is at the top of your head. It's at the top of your body. It finishes off your outfit. And that might help you to understand what caps means in the headline.
Yes. March caps the warmest 12 months means March is at the end of or finishes off the warmest 12 months, just like how a real cap is at the top or end of your body.
Exactly. Now, the last 12 months have been the hottest ever, and March is the most recent month because it was just last month. Okay, let's look at that again. We've had Usher in, Show Where to Go.
On Borrowed Time, lasting longer than expected.
And Cats, Complete.
Now, if you're interested in learning more about the language of climate change, we have other programmes.
And don't forget to click here to subscribe to our channel so you never miss another video. Thanks for joining us. Bye.
Bye.